As the year 2016 has come to an end, let us look back and remember all the things that happened that year. Some of them were great. Some of them weren't. There are a lot of people who say that this year was awful, and there's a lot of people who say it was great. But some of those people who say that it was awful say that they wish they could go back and be in the 90s. And you might have run into these people, you might not have, but I've run into a few, and, you know, nostalgia and stuff. There's a lot of nostalgia being driven, you know, with things like Pokemon Go and, like, Crystal Pepsi came back. There's some people drinking Crystal Pepsi now. It's as if, like, nothing bad ever happened in the 90s, you know, and if it did, you know, we're just gonna say, like, oh, hey, remember when that happened? That was crazy, it shook the world and stuff. It didn't fill us with, like, fear and stuff. It just went like, oh man, that's so crazy. And, like, you know, a lot of bad things that happened in the 90s, like Oklahoma City bombings, OJ was declared innocent, and what I'll be talking about today, Greeny Phatom. Okay, so basically, Greeny Phatom is the show that supposedly started airing in 1995 on Fox or Nickelodeon or something like that, I don't know. So, what is this show about? I don't know. There's like an ant guy in it, and there's another ant guy, and another ant guy. Other and things. Also, there's pubes, and they go around and talk about stuff. I don't know. You want to have a better idea of what this show is about? Take a few thousand doses of LSD, get a BAC of about 0.5, and listen to some Macintosh Plus. If you're still as confused as I am, I wouldn't blame you. So yeah, it's a jumbled mess of things that kids might like, or at least that a very, very select number of people might like. Those people being this community of people on YouTube, mostly like teenagers and stuff, that really seem to like logos, but don't really know a thing about graphic design. Also, there's a lot of kids show references, because anyone old enough to use YouTube would still be watching Sesame Street and Bananas in Pajamas. I'll get more into that later, but for now, let's delve into this thing. And before I start, yes, this was made in MS Paint. I'm really sorry that my first review had to be of something like this. But hey, at least the guy who made it knows how to use a computer. So, on to the review, I guess. So, I guess this is supposed to be a slapstick comedy. I mean, like, one of the episodes, the little guy kills his friend, JFK style. So, yeah, I laughed at that, I guess. And other than that, the comedy is just logos again, because Jolly G Willikers, you never know what to expect from those darn logos. Maybe there's something I'm missing, because for some reason there used to be more than a few fans of the show who fully understood the logo humor. I mean, I get the logos, but what do the jokes mean? You know, they just read CLG signs, and like, they read the captions, and they say stuff, and is that comedy? I mean, I'd ask for help, but anyone that used to like the show either won't talk about it, or just talk about how much they hate it, and they'll just say, like, you know, don't ask me about that, because, like, you know, I hate that show, and you suck for liking it. Either that, or says, like, the same, like, I respect your opinion. But either way, there's pretty much no one I can turn to at this point. Except you guys, right? You guys love me. Fluffy, right? Thanks for loving me, I guess. I'm gonna cut this part out. There seems to be a pretty specific niche for this show, small enough that a lot of people probably don't know it exists, yet big enough to have its own wiki. It was actually pretty well done from what I see, but it seemed to have been a huge target for vandalism. The website had to be shut down because of it, and now it happened again, and they had to move to a whole different place. It really does make you think, are the people who hate the show worse than the fans? One thing that I noticed when first going into the show is the numerous obscure references and sort of inside humor that the show has. I don't know where anything came from the jokes that are obviously stolen, to the background music that I can't figure out the name of for the life of me.
One day, little guy and Dr. Beanson had an adventure to visit to the Paramount Picture CGI Mountain logo for getting there, as it happened for this place.
This all carries with it a sort of strange aesthetic charm of the show.
This looks like a mountain.
It's like, I know what I'm getting into, and I know it sucks, but I'm not watching it for the raw comedic value. I'm just fascinated by how random and stupid it gets. It's the same reason I don't like Gravity Falls, but I love half the shows on Adult Swim that only last for one season. Maybe it's blind nostalgia that drives me to the show. I must find the logos before my Sesame Street VHS tapes are pretty nostalgic if it can push me through this terrible show. But, you know, maybe what I'm saying here is complete and utter bullcrap and I just watch the show ironically and intend on making fun of it in any way that I can. It's hard to tell at this point. Love is just so random and it runs on total nonsense. It really begs the question, what is a guilty pleasure? At what point does something stop being good behind layers of nostalgia and start being good behind layers of irony? Or maybe, corporate America has finally won. They finally made a show so commercial that you can close your eyes and still feel the product placement. And they finally found an audience for it. The consumer. Is the creator of this show really the creator? Or is he just an ad? The world may never know. But one thing we do know is that I'll explain my experiences with the show and uncover the mystery behind it in the second half of this program. I'll just put a commercial here and start walking. I've fallen into the trap of commercialism and I'm not even sorry. And we're back. That was a mighty fine commercial break. Okay, so time for my experience with the show. I'm going to be fairly honest with you guys. I used to see this show posted everywhere back in 2011. Greeny Phatom versions of Sony Wonder. Greeny Phatom versions of Burger King commercials. Greeny Phatom VHS openings. You name it. I thought it was just some sort of loosely knit fandom of these random characters. I couldn't find the original show for the life of me. Fast forward to 2014, when I went back to look for this strange show. I found a Know Your Meme page about Greeny Phatom. The only thing that was there was this text that said that Greeny Phatom was just a bunch of VHS openings. I had no idea what these VHSs had on them, and I still couldn't find the series. Then, in 2015, everything changed. I looked again for more information about this show, and the Know Your Meme page was gone. But in its place was the actual series. Finally, what I had been searching for this whole time. I watched it, and it was awful. Awful, yet captivating. I couldn't help but watch every single episode I could find. So strange, so disjointed, so easy to make fun of. I even watched the movie, even though there was this other movie called Go Animate the Movie that I already watched, and that pretty much ripped off the Greeny Phatom movie word for word. There were also other shows like Geo's World and World of Jake that were similar, but at the time I couldn't tell the difference. So yeah, here I am in my room watching every episode of Greeny Phatom for the next 2 months.
Make.com.
I became immersed in the Greeny Phatom lore. I posted my findings to forums that I won't tell you the names of for privacy reasons. I even tried making my own Greeny Phatom episodes.
I gave up after my computer broke and all the files vanished from existence. I wanted to know what it was that drew me in. I showed my 7-year-old sister the show, and she absolutely loved it. On a side note,
if he puts me in this, I will kick him in his and mother kill him, and I'm tired of soldiers. They are so dang stupid.
Say goodbye to a stupid crowd face crapping song, biatch.
Your Deutsche Funk must have battle leaked.
Applied directly to the foreskin.
Oh, you're a little whore. You smell like a camel's ass.
So any wonder, applied directly to the foreskin.
Bob Beanson pooped all over us.
So any wonder, applied directly to the foreskin.
Very good kids show. You should definitely show your at-risk children this. And then this video came around and solved the mystery of why people love the show, so what else is missing? Who is the creator of this show? Where are all the fans? What do the jokes mean? Well, that's what I'm hoping to answer. So, according to the credits of every Greeny Phatom episode, this show was created by a man named Robert Stainton. A lot of people associate this name with a Canadian university professor, but this has been debunked. As this Tumblr post, which I'll link in the description, shows a video of the man, the myth, the legend himself, with a sportsmanship award in the background with that very name on it. So yeah, this is Robert, and yes, he has more videos of his face.
Hello dear, Officer Griffin was not here. I wore that police officer costume. It looks very comfortable and soft.
He looks to be a teenager in these videos, which were posted in about 2010. So, I actually have a theory. According to the Greeny Tunes Universe Wiki, Greeny Phatom first aired on August 13th, 1995. So, what if this is the day that Robert himself was born? Of course, this would mean that he's actually of legal drinking age, which might explain a thing or two.
Drinking drinks get drunk.
And that brings me to my second question. Where are all the people now who used to be the fans? Well, I looked at the Inspired By section of the credits, and I found that Geoshi1100 is working on something called MyCun. U23-1000 doesn't exist anymore. LucasHerford67 posted one thing on Scratch in 2014 that disappeared. The BuilderMan123 hasn't been active since 2014 either. 2000 Top Gear Dog is still active and occasionally posts on social media. UrbanAngel13, she's active, but, you know, she's radically different from the others, and, like, you know, instead of just posting, like, logos and stuff, she posts, like, Adele and, like, this, like, cool, crazy stuff. I don't know why she's here, because, like, she doesn't seem to be a part of that fandom, or ever has been. Maybe she's a friend of Robert? Anyways, Hidden Mario 1 hasn't been active since 2014, and Duck Plumber II got terminated. I know that's not everybody, but I don't want to get too deep into things, that'll just take forever. And now for our third and final question. What does all this logo humor mean? The answer? I couldn't tell you. Greeny Phatom is a very niche and esoteric show, and it's very unlikely that you'll ever get any of the jokes unless you're a part of the logo community that this show is made for. The most I could dig up was from the Closing Logos group, which specializes in archiving opening and closing logos from movies and TV. There's a lot of inside humor from that group, and I couldn't tell you anything because I don't know anything about it. All I know is that Greeny Phatom is just a fun little show and a love letter to all those dedicated folks. So, is it the best possible gift? Of course not, but it's good enough. So, what do I think of Greeny Phatom? I think it's awful, but I like it. 3 out of 10. Would I recommend it? Yeah, if you have some time off on a Friday night, I wouldn't stop you from watching this and getting a nice little laugh in. So, what's next for Greeny Phatom? I don't know, but there are more episodes of Dr. Beanson on the 2009 Greeny Phatom channel being posted right now, which, in my opinion, is a far better show. There are still fans of this show, Greeny Phatom, but They're often brought down by the immense hate for the show, so my word of advice, don't go too crazy in either direction. Either way, I'm Aureate Joe, and you just watched a video on the internet. I'm out.